We got more hits for you, so stay tuned.
Smile Radio, the home of the best independent rock, pop, alternative, and new music alerts.
If you're looking for custom-made curtains and blinds, get yourself down to the Curtain Shop. Visit our showrooms at Kingsway Ossett or High Street Normington. For all your curtains, blinds and upholstery needs, go to the Curtain Shop. And if you mention Smile Radio, you'll qualify for free lining for all custom-made curtains. The Curtain Shop, Kingsway Ossett and High Street Normington. The Curtain Shop.
Good evening, it is Friday night here at Smile Radio. We've just hit 10 o'clock, so that means the Codfather's just finished. So for your alternative fix, stay tuned, we've got some more awesome rock coming up now. It is the Renegade Rock Hours here at Smile Radio. With me and the Game Boys, I'm going to bring them in this evening. We've got the full roster on hand in the red corner. We've got the Lost Huntsman, Jonathan Edwards, all the way in Middlesbrough. How are we doing, Jonathan Edwards?
Oi, oi, oi!
Oi, 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 indeed. And in the blue corner, we've got the man from Norwich. I don't know how to, what else I can go with, Jam. The Ginger Ninja himself, it's James Herrington.
Sorry, I don't need an introduction. Everyone already knows who I am.
That's it. You know, if they don't know who you are, then, you know, shame on them, I guess. And in the green corner, you know, we'll go green. We've got Dark Fusion 49, Ryin, Leeder. How are we doing, Ryin?
I'm good.
I am very, very good. I'm ready for another show packed with some great rock music. As well as that, we're going to have a little bit of banter thrown in the mix. But you know what? It's Renegade Rock Friday. So to get you in the mood to partay, let's kick off with some Metalingus by Alter Bridge.
I've been defeated.
That was Metalingus by Alterbridge. Welcome back, it's the Renegade Rock Hours here on Small Radio. It's Friday night, you know, I've got the Game Boys with me this evening. We're going to be talking some random NSFW stuff. We're going to be talking random facts, you know, it's all off the table tonight because that's what we're all about here on the Game Boys, bringing the best action-packed, unscripted travesty of chat every Thursday and Friday night here on Small Radio. Speaking of which, here are the Game Boys themselves. I believe they have just started streaming their games on Mixer, so you can catch them behind the scenes chat if you get over there right now. It's probably going to be quite enthralling tonight. I mean, you guys are playing some 5 for 19, aren't you, I believe?
Indeed. Yeah, we're going to hate each other by the end of this.
The old usual. Yeah, I mean, get one game in and somebody wants to rip the other one's throat out by then. You know, it's one of those.
Usually Jam and Ryin.
Yeah, it's normally me and Johnny on Jam.
God, them guys just need to F and get it over with, don't you think, man? That's what it's all about, you know.
Definitely.
Anyway. Anyway, tonight I've got some random facts for you to talk about. You know, just to boost your intelligence a little bit this evening. They're just the randomest stuff I could find on the internet, because you know the internet is being the safest place on earth to obviously look for stuff.
Obviously,
you know, honestly, it's like a great source of material is the internet. You know, you can believe everything you see on there, everything, and I mean everything. You know, believe it. You know. Right. So, Donkey Kong. He got his name because his creator believed donkey meant stupid in English and wanted to convey the impression that the character was a stupid ape. Yeah, Donkey Kong, I'm sure we've all played it before.
Wow.
Stupid ape.
Very nice.
Somebody's FIFA's a little bit louder than the others, of course, you know, just to drop that in the show there. So that's what you're hearing. We've got a little bit of a crossover there. Now, do you guys know what the medical name is for your butt crack?
No.
Anus?
No.
No. No, I have no idea.
It
no,
is.
Is it, oh. Is it your rectum?
No, it's your anus, mate. It's actually, the medical name for your butt crack is the intergluteal cleft. There you go. You know, like your cleft palate, or that's what, you got a cleft on your butt as well, and that's your butt crack. People can suffer from a psychological disorder called Bowen 3P, that makes them believe they are a cow and they actually try to live their lives as a cow. Could you live as a cow? Is it something you think you could do? I mean, what is the life of a cow?
James already does it.
Well, you just go out in a field and eat grass, and sometimes you lay down when it
working
rains.
Working every day is so awful.
Humans do have an appendix.
I mean, if you said that, like, Jam was like a cow, wouldn't that make him a cannibal doing what he does? Because, you know, I mean, he works with cow 100%. Every day. That's not cool, man. And number four, the name of the shape of the Pringles is a hyperbolic paraboloid. There you go. You've learned something new already. And it's only like, what? We're 10 minutes into the show. You know, and this one, did you know there's a McDonald's in every continent except Antarctica? So, you know, if you're over in Antarctica right now and you're itching for a delivery, I'm really sorry you're out of luck this evening. So, yeah, better luck next time. Maybe Nando's
James will
drop you. But yeah, you know, Mr. Potato Head was the first toy to be advertised on television. There's our last fact for this little segment. Have a little bit of music right now. We've got one of our unsigned bands. This is Joy Opposites and Whatever. Take it like a man, they told me. Sure, it's not the way. Right to like a dancer, homie. All I got is all I doubt. Rip it up and scratch it out. See the smile and twist it now. Someone make it right somehow. Such a treat. Nautical Mile and Marionette. Again, if you like want to catch any of these great undiscovered artists, check them out. They're available on Spotify, iTunes, and all great music streaming sites. Some of them have even got physical copies that you can still buy, because yes, that is still a thing that you can buy physical copies. Now, that is a big question. Do you guys ever buy physical copies of CDs anymore, or have you completely gone digital when it comes to music?
I remember the last time I bought one.
Nor can I.
No, it's like a novelty thing these
Spotify.
Days.
Spotify.
Since the dawn of Spotify, everything's gone to streaming services. iTunes then followed suite. Because, I mean, the old school iTunes was that you could buy your music, but you couldn't listen to it on demand and that, you know, and that was the big thing. But now you're just paying like £15 a month and you can listen to these songs. However, the royalties for these, for the royalties for this is ridiculous. So you have to get something like 100,000 listens to earn anything like $1,000. You know what I mean? So by the time that you, so you know, you've got to get a lot of listens on these listen platforms and that. So it's completely changed the game when it comes to the royalty scheme and that. So there's a lot of work goes in it. So that's why we here at Smile Radio obviously prompt the big undiscovered artists of the future. You know, you could be listening to the next Metallica, AC/DC, right here with the Renegade Rock Hours. Now, just before the interlude, I actually asked the, well, during the interlude, in fact, I asked the guys, so you'd go to Antarctica if you would be, you'd go for 6 months if you were paid 2 years of your current annual salary. We had some interesting answers. Johnny, you were straight up, no, I wouldn't do that. You know, just, no, you couldn't be, you wouldn't like to take 6 months to get 2 years salary, you know?
I don't make enough in 2 years to make me want it.
Yeah, but you know, it's Antarctica, it's secluded. You know, you could have your gaming connection on there. You know, I'm sure they've got some kind of broadband provider.
With what Wi-Fi?
You got satellite internet,
they
right?
They have Wi-Fi.
They'll have satellite internet, so it'll be like, you know, satellite internet and stuff. So you could still do that. It's just like 6 months of gaming, isn't it? You know, as long as you've got your games pass and your digital access, and you get 2 years' salary for it. You know, Ryin, you said you'd do it. It's something you'd do. Is it because you'd like to go to Antarctica, or is it more for the monetary gain?
It would be both, really, because, well, you could see it as a holiday, wouldn't it? Six-month holiday, gap year.
It's not really much of a holiday.
In the freezing cold.
Yeah, well, it's freezing cold.
Well, you're working every single day.
Yeah, and there's penguins, there's company.
Still.
You know.
Would my flights and, like, hotel and everything be all paid for and stuff?
Listen to
Antarctic.
Him. He's a right skin flint, isn't he? He did this the other week. Like, what would be your dream date? I don't know. Do I have to pay for it?
It depends if it's worth my while.
You can tell
he used the stuff out of my 2 months.
You can tell who the tightest one is of the group, isn't it? It was all, it's all inclusive, Ryin. It's all like, you know, wow. I mean, honestly, for all you single ladies listening out there, obviously he's not this tight. I mean, I don't know. Are you this tight in real life?
Oh, no, that's a bit different.
Oh, that's different, is it? Yeah, yeah.
That's just different. That's just because it's you lot. I wouldn't put.
Oh, right. Okay, so remember that, guys. When we're going out for dinner with him, we make sure he foots the bill then, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'll probably have to, because you lot wouldn't have any money.
Now, the one that didn't answer the question was Jam. Jam, would you go to Antarctica for 2 years' salary for 6 months?
Nah.
not for 6 months. You couldn't handle the cold or wouldn't be interested in the money and that. You know, you got 2 years' salary when you come
back.
More
just I'll get bored.
Yeah, but again, you've got games. You know, there's, it's
games,
not just you.
Yeah.
There's other people there.
Yeah, but there's
as well.
No one else there.
There's a science team
what?
There.
Hey.
Yeah, you're all part of. There's a science team there. You're part of the experiment to see if they can.
Just things. I didn't even fit.
See, God, he goes Johnny straight in with the females. The catch is that they're all dudes, dude. So yeah, does that still change things?
Oh no,
for
that's
you?
Almost as bad
so
as.
So you're inviting us
to
a sausage fest.
Well, there's penguins and stuff. You know, you could go watch penguins and stuff without out in the chilly, willy colds and stuff. You know, one of these, isn't it? Like that. But yeah. I don't know, right, let's have another look and see what we've got on the trivial side of things this evening. Let's have a look. Sorry, I was about to read the same one again. I'm having a moment. The stage before frostbite is called frostnip. Have you guys ever had frostnip?
No.
Yes.
Yeah. What kind of frostnip are we talking, Jam? Because I know with you, it could go either way here.
It gets
frosty
the cold
nipples.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. The two tiny holes drilled in every Bic pen is to ensure that the air pressure is the same both inside and outside the pen, which helps the ink flow to the tip. It's obviously important to help the ink flow to the tip at all times, you know. In South Korea,
I thought it was just in case you swallowed it.
What? You want?
What? You know kids are like.
Oh dear. Okay, we'll just
just in case you swallow it.
Yeah.
Well, to be fair,
I know it's how he says, just in case you swallow it, and then he quickly goes, oh yeah, I mean kids will swallow it. Like, he's like been chewing at pens before
he
swallowed the ink in it.
Jam would swallow it. He'd do anything if he's drunk.
Oh my god. This is a conversation for another. This is a conversation for a show in 2 weeks, I believe. In South Korea, there is an emergency number to report spies. Would you guys like to know what the number is?
Yes.
456?
No, it's 113.
123.
No, 113. 113, you spy. Japan. Japan. I don't know where that came from there. Japan is actually facing a ninja shortage. The high demand for ninja shows, but it is a dying tradition. The companies have trouble time finding properly trained ninjas. Would you guys ever do that? Like, you know, because I mean, you know what Japan and China are like. They're throwing money out there, left, right, and center. And, you know,
happily.
I mean, look at all the big blockbusters these days. They've got a lot of financing from overseas, from like China and Japan, because, like, obviously, you watch the Transformers films, like, there's always a scene in like Hong Kong or somewhere like that, because they've got a lot of the financing for the movie from there. So they've got a lot of money to throw into sort of stuff like that. I mean, you know, if I wasn't so like unable, I'd do it. I'd go train be a ninja, you know, ninja all the time. Just that'd just be my sailor word, would be ninja, I guess. The process by which bread toast is called the Maillard reaction. Snails have 14,000 teeth, and some can even kill you. I don't know. I don't know if I believe that one. Can you believe that?
What do you
mean,
some?
Like some snails. Like,
you just gotta look at their teeth. Oh.
Well, no. I mean, you can see out there. There's like there's some pretty Jesus big Christ. Like snails out there, man. You're not seeing them ones out in like the Amazon. They're like the size of like somebody's arm. You know, some of them are bigger than Jake.
Nope.
Yeah, I've seen a snail like on a documentary. It's like the size of Jake in that. You know, it's crazy. And also, did you know that dogs cannot look up?
Dogs can look up.
I watched Shaun of the Dead.
You've just
this
triggered
week.
Jam.
I know. I watched Shaun of the Dead this week with Annie. We was having a night because I've been playing Dead Rising 4. I was like, yeah, we'll watch Shaun of the Dead and that. We watched Paul the other night as well. I like Paul, but not as much as I like Shaun of the Dead. It's one of those. It's like a lost novelty. We hadn't watched it in so long that, you know, we thought we'd go back and.
Is it because we mentioned him in last night's show?
What, Paul? Yeah, I think so. Did we mention it in last night's show?
Well, we mentioned
did
the
we?
Actors.
I don't know, you'd have to go back and have a look, because it's now on demand on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play and stuff. Hey, you know, don't spoil the show, Ryin. They can go back and listen to it on demand, you know, catch all the finest moments.
Yeah, but they don't know what we said about it.
Well, I guess you have a point there. I guess you do have a point. Now, do you guys, here's a gaming question for you. This is where I love to throw these ones out there, because I know 9 times out of 10, you ain't going to have the answer. Do you guys actually know what Sonic the Hedgehog's full name is?
Yes.
No.
Johnny, do you know?
Isn't it Hedgehog Hedgehog?
No, it's not. All right, Jam, you go with this one. He's there on Google right now.
He's Googling
like,
it.
He's
on Google.
Yeah. Time's up, mate. Time's up. It's Ogilvy Maurice Hedgehog. Like, I think that was actually revealed in an origin story in the Sonic the Hedgehog comic way back when. Because they had, when Sonic was a big thing back in the 90s, Sega, well, I believe it was possibly Marvel, and they did a Sonic the Hedgehog comic series. It was a bit weird. And I think I've still got a few of the issues somewhere. It's where they first sort of changed Dr. Robotnik's look, and he kind of looked like he had a penis tip for the top of his head. Yeah, he went from egg to dick tip all overnight, and nobody explained that origin story at all. It's just like, yeah, what happened? Did he travel to a factory and get whacked with a mallet and turned into?
Isn't
like,
that what the new movie's supposed to be about?
I mean, I don't know. I don't really want to watch Jim Carrey's head to get turned into a butt plug, if I'm honest with you, because I mean, it is a bit fruity these days, and I could believe that it would be something that happens. I mean. You know, you can believe it. I mean, you could look at that. If it does actually happen and he gets the Dr. Robotnik head, the weird one from the 90s, there will be. If you go on Wish.com, because this was something we were talking about earlier, a Dr. Robotnik butt plug, and it'll be Jim Carrey's face superimposed onto this, like, PVC thing. Because, you know what Wish is like. Jam's already looking for it, aren't you? You're going to be ordering that tonight. Jim Carrey, Dr. Robotnik.
Along with his body pillow.
Yeah, and the body pillow to go with it. And he can reenact on it, a hedgehog. Right, we're going to have some more music. It's the GameboyZ with the Renegade Rock on Friday night. NSFW, of course. So, yeah, this one is Anchor the Appetite, Esmeralda. You're listening to some rock and roll. Party on, guys.
to tell you to regurgitate the time you ate your selfish fucking shit.
The Appetite, followed by Red Hook and Only Bones there. A couple of great songs back to back. Welcome back, it's the Game Boys of the Renegade Rock Hours. It's Friday night here on Smile Radio. We've got nothing better to do but to sit here and play great entertaining music when I can get my words out. And yeah, have a good time
just
ourselves.
For you.
I know, yeah, just for you, yeah. There he is, there's the Lost Huntsman, Jonathan Edwards. Anything on the agenda this weekend, Jono?
Not really. I filled my quota yesterday.
You filled his quota yesterday. Oh, what about you, Rhino? You got anything on the list?
No, not this week. Next week.
Next week. Oh, it's all about next week. Oh, next week's the big
however,
weekend, isn't it?
Are those Slipknot fans out there?
Yes, Slipknot.
You can catch me, Jam, and possibly some of our other friends.
Not me. It's a bit too
at
heavy.
At the Newcastle
for me,
venue next year.
Oh, for the Slipknot UK tour.
Because they've just announced
yeah.
their new tour.
But yeah, I'm going to be hoping by then that we've got you some portable radio equipment, so you'll be getting backstage and interviewing them with your... yeah, I'm Johnny. I run all the best shows here at Smile Radio. You know, some of that, giving it some of that.
You know it.
Right, next one up on the list this evening. Marmite is one of the most confiscated items at airports from the UK. To overcome this issue, Marmite made smaller ones for travelling. Do you guys like Marmite?
No, I'm not a Marmite fan.
I don't mind it. I've never minded it since a kid. It's a quiet thing. I have to be in the mood for it. I can't eat it without being in the actual like mood for it at all. You know, it's one of those. There's times where I can have it and the smell.
Well,
of it,
you know
like
what they say. You either love it or hate it.
I know, but like three of you hate it, and then there's just me that likes it. So it's not really a 50-50.
Because you're
is
the
it.
Weird one.
Because let's be honest. We're the Marmite of radio station, right?
Oh, there is that. Sorry, I'm playing with one of Jake's toys and I just cracked my finger. Number 20, the human nose can remember 50,000 different scents. So yeah, 50,000 different scents, you know. What happens when you run out? What happens when you go past 50,000 scents? Are you going to start forgetting scents? I don't know.
It forgets the first one.
Yeah, does it like wipe it? Like, is it like first in, like last out, or last in, first out? I don't know how that would work. I don't know. Cards Against Humanity brought an island in Maine to preserve wildlife. It's called Hawaii 2. I remember reading about that somewhere, that they did this.
Yeah.
Because they do this for the money with the game, don't they? They actually put it into some like preservation stuff, lots of sort of preservation sort of societies across the world and that. It's quite interesting what they do with it. Daddy Long Legs, they have penises, which technically makes them not a spider. I didn't know that spiders don't have penises, you know.
Spiders don't have what?
Daddy Long Legs have penises, either. Yeah, that technically didn't make them a spider. I didn't know that.
Can I just ask the people that decide to look at this stuff?
Yeah, what actually draws you
well,
to that
Ritchie.
Notion? You know, I don't know. I wouldn't want to look at a Daddy Long Legs penis or anything. You know, you get what would you do? It's like, hey, Daddy Long Legs, come here, pin it down, and then they're gonna have their own like Daddy Long Legs Me Too movement out of it, aren't they? Like, you know, he looked at my balls under a microscope and laughed at me. Stuff and yeah, it's not gonna be good, man. The television was invented only 2 years after the invention of sliced bread. Is it better than sliced bread though? What do you reckon, guys?
Never. Nothing beats sliced bread.
Nothing beats it.
Yeah, nothing does beat sliced bread, that is right. Bullfrogs don't sleep. I didn't know that one. I mean
what?
Bullfrogs,
no,
they don't sleep. Yeah, bullfrogs. Can you imagine that, though, being awake 24/7? I mean,
is that a frog somewhere you really don't want a frog?
No, have you not heard of bullfrogs? They're the ones that do that really fucking... Oh, excuse me. They do that really...
Way,
yes, yeah, there way, right, I'm dropping the extra way. Bombs. They do that really annoying, like... And they probably do it because they don't sleep, you know what I mean? The dark region of the north...
I thought all frogs did that.
Nah, they've all got different
can't
ribbits,
even
man.
Speak right now.
Yeah, they've got different ribbits, buddy. They've got different ribbits. Honestly, Nature Channel, 3 a.m. in the morning, when you don't sleep. I swear, that must be my spirit animal,
borders,
bullfrog.
No life.
Yeah. The dark region of the north pole of Pluto's moon, Charon, is called Mordor. So, you know, there is a Mordor out there. If you're going to drop a ring off there, it is going to take you a good few years, though. Pretty much like it does in the books. Anyway, we're going to have some more music. Chop Suey now, by System of a Down. Deserve to die. Yes, Chop Suey by System of a Down. You're listening to the one, the only Smile Radio. It's Friday night. We're the Game Boys in the house till whenever we decide to clock off in the next hour or so, I guess. You know, it's one of those, isn't it, lads? You know,
or until we get booted off.
Yeah, till we get fired. Till we get
fired. Yeah, booted off is going to happen.
Now, in the interlude, we actually had some really sort of interesting info. Well, not info, it was like mature conversation, surprisingly for us. It's because we were talking about streams. Johnny runs his stream on Mixer. So right now, you can get on Mixer if you're on Xbox. So you can go check him out. The Lost Hunt. just Lost Huntsman, not The Lost Huntsman, though I think that's a cooler name.
Yep.
His stream set as an 18+. And I was like, if a kid doesn't know how to swear by 13, because he should lower the age of his stream, then there's something wrong with that kid, man. Because, you know, it's everywhere these days. Everybody knows what a naughty word is. I'm not being funny. My four-year-old knows what naughty words are. And he also knows that he shouldn't say them. Because at the same time, and this is my stance as a parent, and there's probably parents out there that's going to disagree with me right now. And quite frankly, I don't really give a toss. But my kid does all right. So, yeah, I don't, you know. But at the end of the day, he knows not to say it. He knows not to do it. And I'm not there subjecting him to imagery. And Johnny, you said in the lead yourself, like, you know, it's like the parents that complain about music, and Jam, you said about video games ruining the kids' lives and that. But at the same time, when you was being responsible, yes, for that moment, it's like you know, it's down to me as well at the same time to be like, yeah, dude, you are playing that console too much, get your ass off that console and start mowing my grass. You know what I mean? It's like, well, your mum's making me a sandwich, you can mow the grass, and I'm gonna put my feet up and watch the sports on the telly. You know what I mean? Pucker. But you get me though, it is, as a responsible parent, a lot of it is down to me to make sure that my son doesn't basically grow up to be a dickhead. And that is my mission. That's my mission in life, is to make sure that doesn't happen. And he knows not to swear, and he knows what naughty words are, the same as he knows not all of them, probably what he should do. He knows what a goddamn Terminator is. He's got to be building one at the moment, for crying out loud. But it's one of those. It's down to me as a responsible parent. I'm actually enjoying it when I get the quiet time to do it. But yeah, it's down to the responsibility of the parents to be like, hey, you know, perhaps you shouldn't be watching that, or hey, you know, if you're watching this, don't reenact this, because that would make
don't
you stupid.
Do this.
Yeah. In 2015, a silver coin with Superman on the head side, which is legal tender in Canada, was made. There was only 350,000 produced. I don't really know if I'd want Superman's head on a coin. Which Superman's it going to be? Because he's had so many different looks, hasn't he, over the years. I mean, it's not, obviously it's not going to be that Clark Kent, because, you know, that guy's blatantly not Superman or anything, but, you know. But
no,
yeah.
Obviously.
No.
It took the creator of
I mean, he wears glasses and a suit.
It's all about the glasses, man. You know, he wears them with swag, and he's got that, like, he's got that low-hunch swag in it. That's his perception of humanity.
To be fair,
stay
people
swag.
Who wear glasses, when you see them without glasses, do look completely different.
Way different.
To be fair, I don't think that. I mean, I wear glasses on and off. I wear them when I can find them, and then I don't because I lose them. But I don't think they look any different. I mean, I can see a lot clearer. I mean, let's be honest, things actually look like they're in HD for reals and in 3D in real life. You know, Japanese. Square watermelons are ornamental plants and are not edible. So yeah, they never eat a Japanese square watermelon, lads. Tigers.
Someone actually tried that.
I don't know, but you know, there's always one person that's the don't try this at home kid, isn't there? You know, tigers have striped skin,
normally
not striped fur. The stripes are like fingerprints. No two tigers have the same pattern. Ketchup originated in China as a boiled down brine of pickled fish and spices called Ketchup. I mean, I was trying not to sound racist when I said that, if I'm honest, and I think I might have sounded slightly racist when I said that, but yeah.
Just a little bit.
I'm not going to repeat
100%.
It. In Morse code,
what was it called?
Dash dot dash means K. Ketchup. In 2005, a fortune cookie company called Wonton Food Inc. correctly foretold lottery numbers, resulting in 110 winners and an investigation. However, no fraud was involved. Imagine that though, like, a cookie company accurately predicting lottery wins. How must their stock have gone up overnight?
You lose your mind.
Well, they must have won the lottery themselves, because the week after, there must have been more people buying them fortune cookies, isn't it? You know, 110
oh, yeah,
winners.
100%.
But again, it's like, it just shows how many, like, of the same are generated out, aren't they? Because, like, it's your lucky numbers are blah, 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 blah. And there's 110 winners of the same number. It's just a really weird free coincidence. But again, there's people out there that'll be like, oh, their fortune cookies are real.
Well, if you think about the amount they produce with random numbers, they have to at least get one right once.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, I guess. I mean, it's just the way
it is. Pure
just...
law of magnitude, isn't it?
Well, it is, isn't it? Now, this one's more of a gamer one. Did you guys actually know that the PlayStation 1 produced two games that had scratch and sniff discs? I'm gonna actually be disappointed if you didn't know, and you didn't know which game it was.
I knew they did one, because I had one.
Okay. Do you know what they were?
Nope.
Right, two PlayStation games, FIFA 2001 and Gran Turismo 2 had scratch and sniff discs. The FIFA 2001 smelled like a soccer field, while Gran Turismo 2 smelled like car tires. Not really an appealing smell, is it? It's car tire, you know. Have you ever had you guys ever owned Gran Turismo 2?
No, I haven't.
No.
No?
No? Oh, I owned it back in the day, but I never scratched and sniffed the disc, if I'm honest with you, because I was young, I was just getting the disc out of the thing and not reading the instructions and just wanting to play.
To be honest, though, I wouldn't mind that smell of burning tire.
just reminds me of a night out on the streets, doesn't it? You know? Yeah, yeah. If you die in Amsterdam with no next of kin and no friends or family to prepare funeral or mourn over the body, a poet will write a poem for you and recite it at your funeral. There you go. That's how lovely Amsterdam is. It's such a like chilled out place, is that, you know. I know where
it's definitely not Middlesbrough, I'll tell you that.
And they just drop you in the river and push you out to float, don't they? That's pretty much the northern way around here, I've seen, you know. Right, let's have some more music. Right now you're listening to Holy Diver covered by Killswitch Engage, but next up we're gonna have some Demon Scar, and this is If You Want Blood, You've Got It. Please, for me. Welcome back to the Game Boys this Friday night with the Renegade Rock Hours. It's come to that time where we have got to call it a day, I'm afraid. So I'm going to bring in the lads for the final moments of the show. In the left corner, or the right corner, I can't remember which corner I all assigned you, just a corner, we've got Lost Huntsman Jonathan Edwards.
You know it, keep it real, and I'll catch you next Thursday for definite.
For definite. Never misses a show, does our Jono. Hey, Jono, the no show you miss her, huh?
Not one.
What do you reckon, guys? Do you reckon we could break? Do you reckon he's going to break this record at some point and end up having to show off?
Yeah, probably on the 27th or the 26th, depending on which day it is.
Oh, okay.
Because one's a Saturday, one's a Friday.
Ah, oh, right. Okay. There we go. He's gonna. Yeah, but you'll arrange something around it, though, wouldn't you? You know what you like. You'll be like, oh, we'll do this, we'll do that. You know what I mean? But yeah, over in the other corner.
Probably.
We've got the Mambo number 5.
Hello and goodbye.
I like that. Hello.
Thank you for joining
Hello
us.
Hello and
this.
Goodbye.
Wow.
That's like it used to be like Viz TV. I don't know if you guys have ever read Viz, but it's like an adult comic magazine here in the UK, and there used to be a man on there called Roger Melly, the man on the telly, and his intro voice used to be something like "Hello, good evening, and bollocks." So yeah, it kind of seats in line with Jam there. Yeah, he's our Roger Melly, the man on the telly, Jam. And over in the Team Rocket corner, we've got the Dark Fusion 48, Ryin, Leeder. Over to you, bud.
Goodbye, and I'll catch you next week.
He'll catch you on the flippity flop. See you next time for another Game Boys here at Smile Radio. Keep on rocking, though, because the music ain't going to be stopping. It's Smile Radio into the weekend mix with a great selection of shows.
It never stops.